Okay, welcome to my channel Maths with Mahantisha. Children, in the last class we discussed how areas of two similar triangles, I mean the relation between areas of two similar triangles with their corresponding sides, where we had proved one important geometrical truth that if two triangles are similar, the ratio of their areas will be equal to the ratio of the squares of each pair of corresponding what? Sides. And it is also true, this statement is also true that the ratio of areas of two similar triangles is also equal to the ratio of the what? Squares of their corresponding medians, corresponding altitudes, and the ratio of the squares of their corresponding what? Angle bisectors. That means if you know how to prove that the ratio of areas of two similar triangles is equal to the ratio of the squares of each pair of corresponding sides, in a similar manner you can prove that the ratio of the areas of two similar triangles is equal to the ratio of squares of each pair of corresponding medians, square of each pair of corresponding altitudes, and ratio of squares of each pair of corresponding angle bisectors. Okay, so the proof was discussed in the last class. Today let us discuss another important truth. Suppose, children, you are given two triangles, they are similar and their area is equal. See, if two triangles are given similar, having equal areas, so what will be the relation between their corresponding sides? Let us investigate. Okay, so what I mean to say, I hope you understood, children, you are given two similar triangles and it is also given that their area is same, they are having equal areas. Now the point is, what will be the relation between their corresponding sides? Let us investigate. You will be surprised to know that if two triangles are similar having equal areas, they will be congruent. Means the two triangles will be congruent. Let us prove this important truth. Okay. So what is the question? See, the question is, if areas of two similar triangles are equal, that means you are given two triangles, suppose ABC and DA, these two triangles are similar, see, given, and they have equal area, that means area of triangle ABC, you see, area of triangle ABC is equal to area of triangle what? DEF. How will you prove that these two triangles ABC and DF are congruent? Now to prove this, there no construction is needed, okay? Let us prove it. How to see? Now, let us come to the proof part. You see, as we are given, these two triangles are similar. You know that their corresponding what? Sides will be proportional. Corresponding sides of two similar triangles are proportional. So, since triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF, it is given. Therefore, their corresponding side, that means AB by DE, you see, therefore AB by DE equal to BC and BC by EF, you see, because AB and DE, they form one pair of corresponding sides, BC and EF, it is another pair of corresponding sides of these two similar triangles, and AC and DF, it is another pair, the third pair of corresponding sides of these two similar triangles, so they will be proportional, okay. AC by DF. Let this be equation 1. Also what else we are given? We are given area of triangle ABC and area of triangle DF are same. They are having equal area, you see. So, since area triangle ABC is equal to, you see, since area triangle ABC equal to area triangle DEF, you see. Since the areas of the two triangles are given equal, so what will be their ratio? First find the ratio of the areas of the two triangles. So their ratio will be 1. That means the ratio of the areas of the two triangles will be 1 because they are equal. The areas of the two triangles are equal. So if we take the ratio of the areas of these two triangles, it will be equal to 1. That means you see, area triangle ABC divided by area triangle DEF will be equal to 1. Let this be equation 2. Okay, now come to the next part. Now see, children, again we know that if the two triangles are similar, we have already proved that the ratio of the areas of these two triangles will be equal to the ratio of the squares of their corresponding sides. So that means, again, you see what will be the next step? The next step is, again, see, again, triangle ABC similar to triangle BEF. What does it imply? It implies that area of triangle ABC divided by, like the ratio of the area, area of triangle BEF, you see, as these two triangles are similar, the ratio of their areas will be equal to the ratio of the squares of their corresponding sides. That means area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle BEF will be equal to your AB square by B square. You see, the ratio of the squares of their corresponding sides, AB and D are one pair of corresponding sides. It is also equal to BC square. You see, BC square by EF square. And it is again equal to AC square by DF square. You see. So, this is our next step. That means, since triangle ABC and triangle DF are similar, it is given, so the ratio of their areas will be equal to the ratio of the squares of their each pair of corresponding sides. So, we got this one. Okay. Now, see, here area of triangle ABC by area of triangle DF is 1. And here area of triangle, suppose this is equation 3. Now, you compare equation 2 and 3. If you compare equation 2 and 3, look at the left hand side. Whatever is the left hand side in equation 2, the same expression is there in the left hand side of equation 3. So on comparing equation 2 and 3, what we will get? That means we will definitely get that each one of this expression is equal to 1. Each one of the expression present in the RHS, I mean right hand side of equation 3, will be equal to 1. Therefore, so what will be our next step? Our next step will be, you see, comparing equation 1 and 2. Comparing equation 2 and 3, you see. Now, the right hand side of this equation, that is, this expression, AB square by DE square equal to BC square by EF square. We are comparing equation 2 and 3. Look at the left hand side is same. So, the right hand side must be equal to 1. The right hand side must be same. That means each expression present in the right hand side of equation 3 will be equal to 1. So that I am writing. So equal to AC square by your DF square equal to 1. See. Now if this is the case, you see. If this is the case, then what will happen? Then each ratio will be equal to 1. That means AB square by DE square equal to 1. BC square by EF square equal to 1 and AC square by DF square equal to 1. Okay. Then, what again this will imply? Again this will imply that you see AB square, just multiply D square by 1. So AB square will be equal to DE square. BC square will be equal to EF square. And AC square will be equal to DF square. You see. Now what will be the next step? If square of AB is equal to square of DE, then AB must be equal to DE. Because you know, if A square equal to B square, then A must be equal to B. So, this implies AB equal to DE, BC equal to EF, and AC equal to DF. Thus, what did we get? We got or we saw that the three pairs of corresponding sides of the two triangles, that is ABC, the three pairs of corresponding sides of the two similar triangles ABC and DF are equal. Okay. But what is our aim? Our aim is to prove that the two triangles are what? Congruent. See, we got that the three pairs of corresponding sides are equal. Now, we have to show another thing, because you know, two triangles are said to be congruent if their corresponding sides are equal and their corresponding angles are also equal. Here we got the equality of the corresponding sides. Then we have to show that their corresponding angles are equal. Then only the two triangles will be what? Congruent. So let this be equation 4. You see, let the whole expression AB equal to D, BC equal to EF and AC equal to DF. Let us denote it by say equation 4. Now, how to show that their corresponding angles are equal? Children, it is obvious. As the two triangles are given similar, you know if two triangles are similar, their corresponding angles are automatically equal. So that we have to write. But, so after this step, what we will write? After this step, what will be our next step? Our next step will be as triangle ABC is given similar to triangle DEF. Therefore, their corresponding angles will be what? Equal. That means angle A and angle D, their corresponding angles, you see. Angle B and angle E, their corresponding angles, you see. And angle C and angle F, they are also corresponding angles. So each pair of corresponding angles will be equal as the two triangles are similar, it is given. So you see, let this be 5. Now you see, these two conditions, condition 4 and 5 are sufficient to establish that triangle ABC and triangle DEF are congruent, because their corresponding sides are equal and corresponding angles are also equal. Therefore, from 4 and 5, you see, from condition 4 and condition 5, it is established that triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF. You see, so this is what we wanted to prove. So children, in this particular case, we proved that if two triangles are similar and they have equal areas, then the two triangles will be congruent. Children, I hope you must have understood how this is to be proved. Okay? So, it is also one of the important questions that generally come in the class 10 examination. Okay, children, I hope you understood. In the next class, we are going to discuss the converse of Pythagoras theorem. Already we have discussed Pythagoras theorem, its complete proof. How to prove Pythagoras theorem using the concept of similarity, we have already discussed. In the next class, we are going to discuss the converse of Pythagoras theorem. Okay? So children, I hope whatever I discussed in this class, you must have understood. If at all it is true, please hit the like button and subscribe my channel. Okay? Thank you.